going to help to crowd
crowd control.
I've done that a lot when I was in high school. It was an anti-war march, Vietnam War march, commercial in high school. Yeah. This is Kelly Lincoln here with NetRootsRadio.com, and I am here speaking with
Jamie Bauer from Rise and Resist.
And you want to, Jamie, talk first before we talk about the Mueller, this rally and march. Why don't you tell us a bit about, or a lot about, your organization, Rise and Resist?
So Rise and Resist is a direct action organization, and we formed about 2 weeks after the 2016 election, mostly out of the gay, AIDS, and health activist communities. And basically because we were so concerned about what Trump was going to do, particularly regarding Obamacare, but also about the Supreme Court and a lot of other issues. And that's how we formed initially. And immediately we began to morph and be extremely concerned about immigration, white supremacy, white nationalism, and a host of other issues as Trump really began to show what he wanted to do in his administration.
When you started branching out, I know there were a number of triggers that issued that sparked your broadening out of the scope of Rise and Resist. Was there any one specific issue regarding immigration or immigration in general? Because I know with the Muslim ban, and then it was going to be gay, lesbian, you know, then it was slowly being stretched out to anybody who did not fit his idea of an immigrant.
I think what we did, you know, people say follow the money, but what we did was follow the actions.
Yeah.
So we're a very reactive group because Trump does so much and does it so quickly and so without warning.
Yeah.
And so we started to work on immigration right away because that was what he started to try to dismantle right away. And, you know, we didn't really expect that that was going to be the order that he was going to do things in. But since that plays well to the base, and we were not used to presidents who do all their policy according to what plays well with the base, we thought he was going to do these other things first. But he really focused on immigration so that he could get, quote-unquote, a win, because that's the way he is right away. And so basically we're very reactive, which is why we're here tonight.
Definitely. He works in the case of, I said this earlier. He's a loser, so he hates losers. You know, he sees a loss in himself.
It's a very male thing to not be able to apologize when you make a mistake. It's a
general
patriarchal, you know, if you say like a real patriarchal thing, you're always right, you stick to your lines even, you know, and you don't show any signs of weakness. And for him and for a lot of men, admitting they're wrong is a sign of weakness rather than a sign of strength.
True,
So, you know, he will never admit that anything he did was wrong. He will never admit any of the misogynist attacks he made on women were wrong. That's just the way he is.
There's been a lot of... Don Jr. the other day came out and mentioned that he felt he was going to be indicted. I'm of the opinion that his meltdown yesterday at the presser was because his family is now being threatened directly.
You know, I don't like to read too much into things, and I'm someone who just, I do not subscribe to conspiracy theories at all. So all along, but not all along, for quite a while, Trump said that he wasn't going to deal with Jeff Sessions until after the midterms.
Yes, and he got rid of him.
And he did.
Yes.
And so to me, was I expecting it the same day? But I was expecting it, quote unquote, away.
I think we all were expecting it, but I think we were not expecting was his bizarre meltdown yesterday at the press conference. And like I said, I think it was predicated on the fact his son said, "I think I'm going to be indicted."
Right.
So, and he did make threats about his family and his family business being investigated.
And, you know, for good reason, because, you know, that will go on whether the Mueller is in place or not. And the state of New York has a great opportunity to go after the Trump Organization.
Which they're doing.
Which they're doing. And, you know, people are hopefully going to end up in jail if they broke the law in a very serious way, as they should. So, you know, Don Jr. is in charge of Trump Org right now, theoretically.
Yep.
And I'm sure he will have to pay for what they're doing. And I certainly hope Trump Sr. does as well. But, you know, and Jared and a few other people.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's their fault.
Yeah,
you know, that's not
what...
about vendettas. That's about the fault of their actions.
Yeah, well, you know, he sees it as a vendetta.
No, but it's really not.
It's not, but
it really isn't.
We know, but that's how we perceive it. Yeah.
You know, and he should have seen it coming, because if he had agreed to put out his tax returns and everything else and have some transparency in the beginning, it wouldn't have festered for 2 years.
And innocent people don't scream and shout, you know, witch hunt and all that other stuff. The other thing is with Sessions being fired, a subpoena?
The Democrats will have a lot of power. I hope they use it wisely.
I'm also speaking Mueller.
Mueller can subpoena. But, you know, I hope they use it wisely. And, you know, the important thing is for the truth to come out and to have some sunshine on what's going on and what's been going on and what happened. And, you know, I think having Democrats in Congress can help that happen.
That's an excellent point. Getting back to the logistics of the rally here, that's the bullhorn. They're playing with the bullhorn. marching from here in Times Square down to Union Square. Are you hoping to pick up more?
You know, I think it's a number of things.
Yeah.
The reason why you march is to also help people blow off steam.
Yeah.
And to express themselves. It's very hard to express yourself standing still.
It is. Yes, indeed. Yeah.
And, you know, we did not want people just to show up and have to listen to politicians bloviate
in the way that they do. And they're going to do that in Union Square anyway.
But, so, you know, the good thing is that here, people can gather, we can hang out, we can be with people who feel and think the same way that we do, we can hold our signs and express ourselves, and then walk and chant and go down to Union Square.
Their marshals are meeting right there.
So I need to actually join them.
Okay, thank you very much for taking the time to speak with me.